Hello everyone, this is Sudipto from Technical Potpourri and welcome to my new video. So in today's video, I'm going to talk about all the new Apex features that are coming up along with Winter 25 release. So without any further delay, let's see all these powerful Apex features in action. So before I start, I'd like to let you know that I have a dedicated YouTube playlist where I am covering all the new features that are coming up along with Winter 25 release. So if you go to my YouTube channel, which is youtube.com and then Technical Potpourri, and then if you go to my YouTube channel and click on the playlist, you'll find a playlist called Salesforce Winter 25 release. Clicking on that, you'll find all the videos that I have published so far covering Winter 25 release. So please subscribe to my channel, bookmark this URL so that you came to know about all my upcoming videos covering this Winter 25 release. Okay, so enough talk. Let's jump to winter25.org and see all the powerful Apex features in action. Okay, so the first feature that I'm going to talk today is the support of negative currency in the SQL query. So let's see that in the Salesforce Winter 25 org. So here I am in my org. To have this feature, you have to enable multi-currency in your org. So if you go to your setup and in the quick find, if you search for company information and click on edit, here you'll find there is an option called activate multiple currencies. For me, this option is already enabled, but you need to enable this to use this feature in your org. So with this feature enabled, if I open my developer console and in the query editor, if I write a simple query like select ID, name, amount from, opportunity, and if I execute this query, you'll see most of the amount against the opportunity is positive. Only there is one example here where I have the opportunity negative. Now after this Winter 25 release, what I can do, I can put the where condition where I can use the negative values in the currency field. So if I write like this way, cat minus 1000. And why I'm doing CAD, because my default currency is Canadian dollar, that's why I'm CAD. But if your default currency is INR or USD, you need to mention that accordingly here. But what is this query is telling? Give me all the opportunities where the amount is less than minus 1000. If I execute, this is the result I'm getting back. What is telling is that after 2025 release, you can have the negative currency values in your SQL query. Okay, so the next feature that I'm going to talk today is about how you can restrict modifying the collection while doing the iteration inside that collection. So for that, I have written a class. So let's go through the class. So here is a class. The class name is collection modification. And inside the class, I have a function called remove country starts with A. Inside the function, what I have done, I have created a set called country names. And inside that set, I have added a couple of country names. Here inside the for loop, I'm doing an iteration inside this collection set. And what I'm doing, if the country name starts with A, I'm removing the country from the list. So basically, while doing the iteration, I'm modifying the content of the collection. Now, let's make sure the API version of this class is 61. Why 61? The reason being is that Winter 25 brings the API version of 62. What I have done, I have written this class in a version which is lower than the current version. So now if I execute this class in my developer console, so let's open my developer console here and let's execute this class. I see there is no error being given. So that doesn't mean that this class has written in a very correct way, because modifying the content of a collection while doing the iteration can create some unexpected result at the end of the execution of the class. So that is why after 62 API version, or starting from 62 API version, what Salesforce is doing, Salesforce is not allowing you to modify the collection while you're doing the iteration. So now I have modified the API version in 62, which is the latest version. And if I execute the same method again, What I will get is basically a final exception, and the exception is telling that I cannot modify a collection while it is being iterated. So that's correct, because what Salesforce is telling, while you're doing an iteration of a collection, you should not modify the collection. Modifying the collection in this way can create some unexpected behavior. So starting winter 25 release, Salesforce will not allow you to do that and throw an exception. So I think this is a very powerful enhancement in the platform. So the next feature that I'm going to talk about is like how you can write your mock SQL test around external object. So before doing that, let's understand the basic differences between external object and the custom object. Custom object normally ends with _C, where external object _E. Custom object normally stores data inside Salesforce.org, where external object doesn't store data. It actually fetches data from some external sources when it is read in real time. So now, when you create your Apex class around the custom object, to deploy that Apex class into production, you need to write test classes to get test coverage. Now, how you normally write that, we normally, inside the test method, we create a test setup function, create our test record, and inside the test method, we normally query those test record and then pass those test record through the original implementation and make sure our expected results we are getting. So this is how we normally do that. But external object is a special one. We cannot create a test record inside a test setup method around external object. So after winter 25 release, Salesforce is giving you the option to write your mock SQL statement around your external object. So this is a very important topic and it needs a dedicated video. A couple of days back, I published a dedicated video around this topic. So if you go to my YouTube channel, Technical Potpourri, and you can search for the video here inside the search. If you can search with mock SQL and enter, it should bring the video how to write mock SQL test for external object. This is the way. Or if you know my winter 25 release playlist, you can go to the playlist and from there you can find the video. But I'll still provide the link of the video in the description as well as in the top right corner. It's very important that you please go through that video and understand this important powerful feature, because this is something you definitely need if you have written Apex class around your external object and you want to deploy that into your production. Okay, so with that, let's talk about the next feature. So the next feature is I'm talking about is like how you can track your unexpected exceptions in the event browser. So for that, if you go to your Salesforce.org and from your setup, if you go to in your quick find, if you go to event monitoring and go to event log file browser, you will find an option here which will tell you to give your start date and end date and filter out all the event types and what interval you want to fetch the data. Basically, this window is basically give you all the option to find out all your unexpected events that happen inside your Salesforce.org within the specified time window. And event types, there are a couple of event types, API, Apex callout, Apex exception, all the event types that are supported is being shown here. You can always change the start date and end date based on your need. For example, if I put September 26 to 29 and click on apply, it will give me all the events that have happened within this time frame. So this is also a very powerful feature that is coming up along with winter 25 release. Okay, so that's all for today. I hope you like this video, and if you like this video and if you find this video helpful, please share this video with your friends, with your colleagues, so they came to know about all the new features that are coming along with winter 25 release. And finally, please subscribe to my channel and click on the bell icon to enable notifications so that you came to know about all my upcoming videos. Till then, thank you. Bye bye.